Hello, my dear students. As you all know that because of the present scenario, our classes are being delayed a bit. But we want that you should all continue with your studies. So we will be beginning with a series of lecture on political science. And you just make a note of all the lectures and should keep a track with all the details. So as you all know, in class 12, there are two main books of political science. One is the contemporary world politics, and the other in which we study about politics in India since independence. So today we are beginning with the book on contemporary world politics, in which we will be dealing with the world in totality, right from the Cold War era to the formation of the various international organizations and the role that they are playing in the world politics. So the first topic, the first chapter is the Cold War era. Now first of all, you should all know what is the difference between a Cold War and what you could say a hot war. So a Cold War is a term which is used to combine all the tensions between any two powers or any two countries without any actual conflict between the two. On the other hand, the hot war or the real war means the involving of weapons and a real clash between any two countries or powers. So as we are dealing with the Cold War era, so what led to the Cold War? The Cold War between the Soviet Union and the United States of America, that is the United States. So the reason between both of them began with the Cuban Missile Crisis. Now what is the heard about Cuba, which was an ally of the Soviet Union and received financial and diplomatic aid from the Soviet Union. As a result, Nikita Khrushchev, a leader of Soviet Union, what he did, he converted Cuba into a Russian base. And in 1962, he placed certain number of missiles in Cuba. All this was enough to create a series of tension in the American bloc. Why? Because they thought that probably Russia is getting ready for any kind of war. As a result, in retaliation to the placement of these missiles, what America did, that America placed its warship to intercept any kind of movement of the ships from Soviet Union to Cuba, so that they cannot use Cuba to target the American bloc. Why? Because America was in close range of these missiles. All these problems between both of them, as a result, when Soviet Union saw that America was undertaking all these issues just to stop any kind of war in this field, so Soviet warships went back to the Soviet base, and as a result, a series of tension developed between the Soviet Union and the American bloc. The American leaders, Kennedy, okay, the American leader Kennedy, what he did, he made it a point that he will put a check on the Soviet leader, that is Nikita Khrushchev, so that no kind of real clash or no kind of nuclear weapons or use of such type of missiles should be undertaken, because that would have been harmful both for the American bloc as well as the Soviet bloc. As you all know that the world was basically divided in these two blocs. These two were the major powers, the Soviet bloc as well as the American bloc. So this tension, which began from the Cuban Missile Crisis, was the basis of a very important condition, and that is the condition of Cold War between these two power blocks of the world. So in the coming up lectures, we will be discussing the other important conditions which came up as a result of this crisis, that is the Cuban Missile Crisis. So in this chapter, we will be dealing, in the coming up lectures, we will be dealing with the other concepts of the Cuban Missile Crisis and the Cold War.